Amen. I want to thank God we've been here since Wednesday. I want to appreciate the bishop for giving us an opportunity to come and minister to the church. Bishop Jacob Kamere from Nyeri. I work with a ministry called Living Faith Ministry. And I'm just here visiting my daddy. So I'm at home. Amen. Go with me to the book of 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel. From verse 1. 1 Samuel from verse 1. Then Nahash the Ammonite, came up, 1 Samuel chapter 11, if you can do it in KJV. Then Nahash the Ammonite came up and encamped against Jabesh Gilead. And all the men of Jabesh said unto Nahash, make a covenant with us, and we will serve you. And Nahash the Ammonite answered them, on this condition, that I will make a covenant with you, that I may thrust out all your right eyes, and lay it for a reproach upon all Israel. And the elders of Jabesh said unto him, give us 7 days respite, that we may send messengers unto all the coast of Israel. And then if there be no man to save us, we will come out to thee. Then came the messengers to Gibeah of Saul and told the tidings in the ears of the people. And all the people lifted up their voices and wept. It's a sad thing. And behold, Saul came after the herd out of the field. And Saul said, what aileth the people that they weep? And they told him the tidings of the men of Jabesh. And the Spirit of God came upon Saul when he had these tidings, and his anger was kindled greatly. And he took a yoke of oxen and hewed them in pieces, and sent them throughout all the coasts of Israel by the hand of messengers, saying, whosoever cometh not after Saul and after Samuel, so shall it be done unto his oxen. And the fear of the Lord fell on the people, and they came out with one consent. And when he numbered them in Bezek, the children of Israel were 300,000, and men of Judah 30,000. And said unto the messenger that came, thus shall you say unto the men of Jabesh Gilead, tomorrow by the time the sun be hot, ye shall have help. Tomorrow by the time that the sun be hot, ye shall have help. I want to prophesy here this morning, in the next 24 hours, when the sun, let me tell you something, these people of God needed help. How many need help from the Lord today? Not from a man, but from the Lord. And they made a mistake. And I want to just to speak about three things, and I'll quit this morning. That number one, we need to put our trust in God. Because these guys they were about to make a wrong decision. Because when they needed help, they sought help from the enemy. You can't ever seek for help from the devil. You can't ever seek help from the enemy. He cannot help you. Hallelujah. David said that I will lift up my eyes unto the Lord, because I know where my help cometh from. My help cometh from God. Hallelujah. When we put our trust in God, we can rely in Him even when things are hot in life. Tomorrow, go and tell the men of Jabesh Gilead, when things are hot, when the sun is the hottest, when the situation is the hottest, our Jehovah God is able to send help. Hallelujah. Deliverance Church, I came to tell you that help is on the way. It doesn't matter how long you have waited for God. Weeping may endure in the night, but joy comes in the morning. Pain may endure during the night, but I tell you, your morning has come. Why? Because the steadfast love of our God never ceases. His mercies are new every morning. Great is His faithfulness. I want to tell somebody in this service today that His mercies have been renewed on you, and I prophesy a 24-hour miracle coming your way. You better shout hallelujah. This guy has made a mistake. And when we are under pressure, we are bound to make wrong choices. We are bound to make wrong choices. But let us understand that our God is not like a man. God is not like a man. He can never fail you. Even when we are going through issues, painful issues, He feels the pain with you. Don't you be disappointed that God has not heard you, because help is on the way. We just need to trust Him. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, we need to trust Him. These fellas, they went to the enemy for help. And this guy wanted, he said, yes, I can give you help, but so long as I remove your right eye. Just imagine believers who are walking in Zimmerman, and you see men and women without a right eye, and you know these are the people of God. Their God has failed. But I came to say, our God will never fail. He is alive, and because He is alive, we can face tomorrow. Because He's alive, you can face tomorrow. Because He's alive, your children will conquer the gates of their enemies. Because He's alive, your business is not gonna collapse. Because He's alive, your marriage is gonna be lifted up from glory to glory, from faith to faith, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We learn to put our trust in God. If we learn to put our trust in God, then we can wait on Him, because they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. It doesn't matter how long you have waited on God. He has the ability to cause you to renew your strength, no matter how old you are. David waited patiently. When he was in the pit, he said, I waited patiently. Psalms 40, I waited patiently upon God. Remember something, when you are in the pit, there is only one place you can turn to, by looking up. Hallelujah. And when you look up, there is help. I came to tell somebody, some may trust in the chariots, others in the horses, but we in the Deliverance Church, we will put our trust, we will put our faith in the name of the Lord, because they that have an experience God. I don't care what mountain you're carrying this morning. I don't care what is coming against you. God will put on his military regalia and he will come and fight your battle, because the battle is not yours. The battle belongs to God. I hear the Spirit of God say, stand still and see the salvation of God. Is there anything that shall be impossible with the God that we serve? Is there anything that can hinder this God that I'm talking about? Is there anything that is impossible with God? Hallelujah. Some of you have waited for too long on God. But the Bible says that David waited on God. And then you know what he did? He removed him out of the pit, and he caused his feet to step on a solid ground. I prophesy to somebody in this service today, God will cause your feet to stand on a secure ground in the name of Jesus. Even when the world is shaking ground, there's Jesus. When he gives you a position where you will stand upon, it is not a shaking ground. It is not a ground that can sink. Hallelujah. It is a secure ground in the name of Jesus. And I prophesy promotion to somebody who is hearing my voice. I prophesy increase to a business that is being represented in this service in the name of Jesus. They went to the enemy for help. Number two, never make a covenant with an enemy. Make a covenant with God. Because when we make a covenant with our God, there is a power in that package, in that covenant that God has given us. There is a power that we can invoke when we are in trouble. Right. Hallelujah. David, when he encountered Goliath, then Goliath came with him with the big size, with the spears and with a big shield. And David looked at him and he said, you come to me with a sword. You come to me with those weapons. But I want to tell you that our weapons are not carnal. Our weapons are mighty through God to the pulling down of stronghold. And David began to swing just a little stone from the river. Just a little stone. Listen to me. People of Zimmerman, what do you have in your hands? What do you have? You have something in your hands that can cause you to conquer your battles. David just looked down the river. He picked a few stones and a bear. Just a bear. If a bear can give a boy like David victory, there is something in your hands that you can use. Hallelujah. Miracles are not in heaven, and they are never in heaven. Miracles are in your hands. Hallelujah. Miracles are in your mouth. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. Begin to speak words that will begin to edify you. Hallelujah. David began to invoke the power of the covenant. He said, you come to me with your might and with your strength, but I come to you in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We don't fight with our physical weapons. We fight with the spiritual weapons. And today I release spiritual weapons in the name of Jesus. Tomorrow. Hallelujah. Verse 19. Thus shall ye say unto the men of Jabesh Gilead, tomorrow, by the time the sun be hot, ye shall have help. When it is hottest in your life and you cannot bear in that situation, you want to compromise in that situation, you want to get in a covenant with the devil, that's when the power, that's when the deliverance comes from your maker. When you're about to give up, when you're about to let go, Saul told the people, tomorrow tomorrow, go and tell those people, because I've been raised by God to govern them. I've been raised by God to watch over them. Go and tell them, help is coming. When? When the sun is hottest. When the situation is hottest. Hallelujah. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, when they were meant to compromise their faith and they refused to compromise their faith, when the situation was hottest, because they put them in a fiery furnace. Daniel chapter 3. Hallelujah. Daniel chapter 3. Verses 16 to 19. When it was hottest, when they could not bear the heat. Listen to me, people of God. Because they have been told to worship, to worship, to worship another image. Listen, we can never worship any other God. No matter who is preaching to us, if there is anybody that is going to preach any other gospel that Bishop Kemani did not preach, we are not going to receive it in the name of Jesus. If anybody is preaching a gospel our father Bishop Mark did not preach, we are not going to receive it. Shadrach, Shadi, Meshi, and Abednego. I said, no, she's a daughter. Sisi tunamjua God wetu. We know our God. Sisi tunajua mzee ule tunamoshim. Sisi tunajua Buddha yetu ni nani. We will not worship, and they were thrown in the fiery furnace. But let me tell you something. When the time, when the furnace was heated 7 times hotter, then in that situation of hotness, they saw another man, and King saw another man walking for their support, walking to aid them, walking to support them. And they said, did we throw in 3 men? But I see a 4th man, and the 4th man looked like the Son of God. Hallelujah. When things are hot, child of God, Jesus will not even send an angel. Jesus will not send a beam from heaven. He will come himself. Hallelujah. Because you are made in his image and after his likeness. Hallelujah. He will not send an angel for you. He will come. Tell somebody, Jesus will come. Tell him again, Jesus will come. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego said, no matter how hot you can make the furnace, we know, we have faith, we have confidence with our God. We have a covenant with God. He said he will protect you. He who watches over Israel, he who watches over Kenya. How many times that Kenya came to a blink of going to the dot, but God was alive and our nation remained intact. Hallelujah. He who watches over Kenya will not sleep, neither will he slumber. Oh, come on, somebody shout, yes. He's alive. When you go to sleep, he never sleeps. And let me tell you, somebody seated here, your spirit neither goes to sleep. Your spirit is alive. God was there with the boys. Hallelujah. When things come to that state of pressure that you can never bear in life, heavens will walk in and support you. Hallelujah. The Lord sent prophet Isaiah, Isaiah 38 verse 3. The prophet is sent to go and prophesy to King Hezekiah and tell him that he's gonna die because he's not kept his house in order. And the prophet comes. How many know Akurino? I love when they give a prophecy, because Akurino will come, give you a prophecy and run away. These days we want prophetic word and we begin to, you know, to reason with the prophecy. A prophet, a real prophet,
will come, give you a word, and run.
Hallelujah, like I'm doing. I'm giving you a prophecy, and after the second service, I'll run to you.
The man was given a prophetic word that he was about to die. And the prophet ran away. But before the prophet got to the gate, this man of God, King Hezekiah, he turned against the wall and he began to cry. And he said, God, the dead do not know how to praise you. The people in the grave cannot lift up their hands and worship you. And you know what? That pleased God. And right there, the moment this guy is supposed to die, God tells the same prophet, go back again. You know something? When you turn against the wall, you can never see yourself well. But somebody else, the leaders who are over you in this church, they have the ability to see you in a different way.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So the prophet is told to go. Thank God, this was not like Jonah, because Jonah was told to go to Nineveh and he said a word of deliverance to God's people and he rejected it. This prophet now comes back. Imagine somebody who prophesied to you a prophetic word that is doom, and now God sent him back. Hallelujah. And God says, I'm giving you another 15 years because I love people who worship me. Just take 1 minute and just worship him. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody worship him. Come on, somebody worship him. 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 Rebo Koshata. Rekama Kantoru Boshaya. Come on, somebody worship God. I don't care what you're going through. There are people who are here who are like Job. Listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to me. Job. An enemy attacked his home. But Job learned to worship God. When he had things, and when he didn't have anything. I don't want things. I don't want blessings. I want the blesser. I want the blesser. Not that those things are bad, but everything I ever needed in my life is in the hands of my blesser. I seek the first the kingdom and it's all righteousness, then all these other things begin to follow me. Can you worship God in pain like Job? Because when everything was taken away from Job, he knelt down and he said, God, even though you slay me, I will yet praise you again. It doesn't matter what pain I go through, it doesn't matter what disappointment I go through, I will yet praise you because I have learned to trust you and to establish a relationship with you. Tomorrow, by the time that you think you can't bear that pain you're going through, I prophesy that God will come. Tomorrow, by the time the sun be hot, by the time that situation is almost getting out of hand, is somebody hearing what I'm saying? By the time the devil is about to give a testimony of how he has defeated you, help will come from heaven, because God is never late. He's never late. So we must learn all the time to put our trust in God and and never go to the enemy for help. Never go to people who despise you for help. They don't know. They don't know. They don't know. They can't bear the pain that you go through. They cannot bear the pressure that you go through. But there is a God in heaven. Our God is real. You know, I've heard about gods who are capped by the hands of men. They have hands, but the hands cannot do anything. They have legs, but their legs can never move. They have ears, but their ears can never hear. But listen to me, our God, his eyes are moving to and fro, looking for one person in the Reverend Zimmerman Church with a perfect heart. All you need is a perfect heart. Perfect. Perfect. Let us be believers who go to churches and have hearts that are changed by God. Hearts that are transformed by God, because hearts that are transformed by God are loving hearts. You can forgive and let go. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Tell somebody, tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Tell somebody again, tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
I need this prophetic message. A young man, banker. Actually, he comes from US. United, where? What is that? Actually, that man is from Seattle. I made that prophetic quote 2 Sundays ago. I was preaching the same message, and that man grabbed it. And he's a banker. And they work in the bank with targets. How many bankers do we have here? And when the man went to the bank that week, what the bank had made the target for a whole week, this one single believer had made half of the bank target. Some guys from outside came with $500,000 to bank. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, tomorrow, the miracle we are talking about will come. Peter was put in prison, Acts chapter 12, verse 5. And prayer was made without ceasing, because Peter was going to be beheaded the following morning. But that same night, when prayer was made without ceasing, listen to me, when pressure was too much, when they couldn't bear it again anymore, listen, if it is some of you in the prison and you're about to be executed the following day, you will not even sleep. But when God sent an angel to Peter, Peter was asleep. Asleep. And look at verse 10, chapter 12, Acts 10, 12, verse 10. The angel of God came, and there was a soldier on this side, there was another soldier on this side, and he patted on the face. Listen to me, I declare manifestation of angelic beings. Some of you don't even know that angels are our servants. They are called to serve us. They are called to minister to us. The angels came, and look at, and when they were past the first gate, because now Peter is set free. Listen to me. You can be a man or a woman of God in a prison cell, in a prison room, but the four walls will never contain you, because you are in prison, but you're not a prisoner. I said you're in prison, but you're not a prisoner. You're free. And the angel led him out of the city. When he was supposed to be dead, what are the gates opening supernaturally? And the iron gates that leaded into the city, which opened to them of his own accord. Because Peter is made out of flesh and blood, he needed the gate to open, but the angel did not. The angel can go through a solid wall like this. Hallelujah. Some of you are looking at me and saying these things are not real. Listen to me, angels are real. And they are surrounding this church right now. There is no Ashabab that can try to come here. We are standing in the holy ground, and where they are angels surrounding this place. Peter was ushered to his destiny when his time to die had come, and he believed the message. Hallelujah. Finally, number three. I talked about how we can trust God and how we can refuse to make covenant with the enemy. Don't make a covenant with the enemy. Young girls, don't make a covenant with the enemy. How many young guys are here? You are not married. Stand up. You are here, you are not married. Don't make a covenant with the enemy. Don't be desperate. Don't be desperate to make wrong choices. Amen. Don't be desperate. You are the generation that we are relying upon to take the church to a next level. Hallelujah. Even when things will be too hot for you, my brother, my sister, God has a way of delivering you out. And don't hook up with the wrong boy. Don't hook up with the wrong girl. Don't make poor choices. The prodigal son made poor choices. He made poor choices of geography. He said, I will leave my father. I want him to give me everything I have. And he left the father. And he went to a far country. But thank God, when things were hot, the boy came back to his senses. And he said, I'll go back to my father. Because even the servants in my father's house, they live better than I do. Hallelujah. And he came back. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. You may be seated. God bless you. So the men of Jabesh Gilead, on the seventh day, they received help. I want to declare victory is on the way. I want to declare victory is yours in the name of Jesus. And on the seventh day, listen to me. The Bible says in 1 Samuel chapter 11, verse 11, and it was so on the morrow that Saul put people in three companies. When that situation is hottest in life, I prophesy to you, God will give you a divine strategy. God will give you wisdom. God will give you ideas. Listen, God gave King Saul a divine strategy and divided the people into three companies. In the morning, he sent one company. But before the sun was hot, the enemy was totally destroyed. I want to declare, before the sun is hot tomorrow, I say before the sun is hot tomorrow. I say again before the sun is hot tomorrow. I say again before the sun is hot tomorrow. I say again before that situation go out of hand tomorrow. God will send help your way. I say God will send help your way. Because it's not by might, it's not by power, it's by the Spirit of God. I release divine blessing to the glory of God. Jesus' name. Put that hand down. I want you, every eye close, every head bow. Some of you are here and you're a target for the enemy. Let me tell you, the enemy is waiting when the sun is hottest so that he will put you in his chain. And he will steal and destroy the destiny of God in your life. But if you have had the word today and you embrace the call of God, he will set you free. Are you here? You're not born again and you want to receive Jesus. Lift up that hand. Lift up that hand. I want to pray for you. Those in the balcony, you are here. You've never received Jesus in your life. Show me. Lift up that hand. We want to pray. I want to pray and speak a blessing over your life in the name of Jesus. You have made wrong choices in life, but God is saying, it doesn't matter. I can give you a second chance. Lift it higher. Don't you shy. Don't you be ashamed. Lift it higher. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. I'm not calling you to a man. I'm not calling you to a system. I'm calling you to Jesus. Lift up. Show me that hand one more time. I know there is a man here. I know there is a man here. Lift up that hand. I know there is a person here. Don't shy away. Show me. Lift up that hand. I want to pray for you before I sit down. In Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. Hallelujah. Tell somebody tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Tell somebody tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
How many believe that it's possible? How many believe that it's possible? Let me tell you something. You can go to your office. You can go to your office and find a letter. I went to Lodwa. And I said, there is a teacher here. And I said, I am declaring promotion for you. Before we finish the service that day, somebody came running from this woman's home because she had received a letter from the government office. Because in that place, there was no woman who had been promoted to a level of a headmistress. That letter from the director's office promoted that woman to the top position. A member of our church was transferred to Baringo. She was working in a hotel as a copy typist. And she went. And it so happened that the president, the former president Moi, was coming to close the convention. And she was the one in charge. The managers were away. And Moi wrote a letter and said, this woman is not a material. This woman is a material for management. She was promoted from a copy typist to a deputy general manager. Tomorrow. The words I speak are spirit and life. I am saying tomorrow. You shall receive help in Jesus' name. Yes. I'm going to appreciate you.